Hey, it's John from Enduring Charm. So this is kind of a oddball project I'm going to be sharing with you here. What you're looking at here is kind of a train wreck, but it's the beginning of a digital audio workstation or a DAW. And when you're recording music or creating music, you need a way to get analog signals from microphones and things like that into a computer. So there's interfaces that you use here like this, and eventually gets into a computer. And you can also use MIDI keyboards and things like that to get into the computer, and you can work with it there. Trouble I'm having here is there's really no system here, a desk of some sort to organize all this. So you got a computer up here, which is kind of in the way on the desktop. You got the monitor the wrong height and a sketchy stand here. The keyboard for the computer is not really well placed, and the musical keyboard or MIDI keyboard is not placed well either. So, and I got a laptop sitting over here which controls some of this other stuff. So it's just a mess. There's speakers which I just recently came up with a solution. These are not where they normally stand. This will be behind the monitor. But there's such large speakers that some kind of stand was needed, and I determined I could find these plastic shelving units for $16. Which is cheaper than I can buy the wood to make a stand. So for now, we're just going to go with that. So I need some kind of stand, and you could purchase stands. Here's an example. There's different types and styles, but you can purchase these things, and they usually have a place for the keyboard at the bottom, musical keyboard, I mean, and then another space up here for, computer keyboards, and another space yet above for monitors, and you may have areas for amplifiers or whatever, things like that. So the main thing is that the keyboard itself, musical keyboard, has a height associated with it, which is ideal, and it's just like a piano. So we want to try to get that if we can. And I'm looking at some of these desks, and the costs are quite high. I mean, you can spend $1,500 without blinking, and for what they are, there's really not much there. So I'm going to see if we can make our own in the shop here. Now there's going to be two things that I'm looking at. One is cheap, so it's going to be a cheapskate project for sure, and the other is functional. And cheap comes first. So I'm going to be looking at whatever leftover wood I have to use in this project. I'm going to try to make it as cheap as I can. Now, one thing I already checked out, this laptop really needs a place to be. And ideally, it would be placed in the air, in other words, off the work surface. I did look at several ways of doing that myself, and I just couldn't come up with a way that was any cheaper than buying an arm online for $33. So I'm sure it's not very good quality, but all I need to do is really get that off the surface. So for $33, I went ahead and purchased that. But everything else I'm going to try to do with just leftover scrap wood. When I go to the scrap pile here, I have some pine here I could use, some decent sized pine there. And if we go out to the scrap area here, I got all sorts of scrap in here. I got more up here I can use. So there's a bunch of scrap wood I can use. And the main thing, though, honestly, is the large surface. So I'm looking through my other scrap pile here. I have a whole bunch of 3/4 inch plywood I can use. And I think plywood is going to be the answer because, again, cheap and simple is what I'm after here. I want it functional, which is mostly a matter of getting the heights correct, and layout and size correct. Now, I want to make clear this is not going to be fine furniture that we're building here. Cheap and functional, that's all I'm after. So if you're in a situation where you need a desk, maybe for, a teenager or something like that, in your household, anything where you need an inexpensive desk along the same lines here, I think you can use the same principles. All right, I got some rough measurements here, just a quick little sketch. Now, these measurements may need to change depending on what scraps of wood I have available, because I am doing this on the cheap, let's remember. But I did find a piece for the top here, the main section, and it's a piece of radiata pine. Radiata pine? I don't know how. Anyway, it's basically a veneer plywood, but it's got a fairly thick veneer to it on one side, The other side is not really usable, but it's going to be underneath, so it doesn't matter for me. So this scrap will do fine for me. Okay, I'm wrapping these edges with just pine, which kind of matches the finish I got here. Now all I'm going to do is, you've seen me do this a million times before, is I cut my 45 on here. I'm just going to glue this using wood glue, and I have a brad nailer just to basically temporarily tack it in place. If you don't have this, no big deal. You can use clamps. You can even wrap it with masking tape. Anything will do, really. So we'll just get this nice and glued up. A little squeeze out is normal, but let's get the worst of that up. Now I can, this particular plywood, this veneer is thick enough where I can do a very light sanding and I'll be okay. So I have that in the back of my head that I can get to that if I need to, but otherwise you want to be careful of too much squeeze out here. All right, these are the side pieces now, the main side pieces. Now a couple things about this, I am gonna kind of take a little bit out of the middle here, and the point being I'm gonna kind of create a foot here and a foot on the other side. Otherwise I have this entire flat area against the floor, and if a floor is slightly uneven, it tends to, you know, cause trouble there. So by taking out some in the middle here, I leave a foot on either side, and that will sit on the floor nicely. Now I'm just going to cut this out with a jigsaw, and I might relieve this edge later with a router or something like that. The sides of this, though, the sides of the side, I am going to put something on here, both for structure and for looks. I don't want to leave this band of the plywood exposed. Now I could just wrap it like I did the other piece, but I'd also like to have a little extra meat here just to prevent the side from warping on me. So I'll probably do that next. So let me cut out these pieces here. Okay, so here you see what I mean. I got this little piece here that I've cut. I just relieved the inside edge here, and that'll cover the plywood. Now this is the inside of the desk. So in other words, this part faces inside to the desk. And I'll nail and glue this, and that'll provide strength for the plywood so it doesn't warp on me. This is on both sides, and it also just looks a little nicer. So this right here is a T-nut. It's designed to be embedded in wood, and then I can use a bolt on the other side to capture that. And I'm going to be using these in some areas because it just makes it easier to make this kind of a modular setup where I can take things apart, move it, and put it back together without too much trouble. So this right here is the cross brace, which will go between the two sides. And I'm kind of getting this ready so that I can set up this modular system. So I'll take one of these T-nuts. I already have two embedded here. The way they work is they just have little prongs right here. And you drill a hole first, just drop that in the hole, and give it a whack with a hammer. And that'll hold in place. So now I have three of these. I'll put three more on the other side. And then this is going to get glued and nailed to the end here. So now I can take a nut from the sides pieces, a bolt from the side pieces and through this and, you know, grab that nut on the other side, pull everything together. All right, now we have the cross braces in. You can see better what I was talking about before. I'll just have these bolts, these are just loosely in here right now, but I'll have these bolts that are sticking out. You'll see the head, but and I'll have a washer there, but it'll be painted black, so it really won't show. So I'll have that. The back of the desk will look like this, and I will have a power strip across the back here, so I got to work on that another time. But this cross brace is very important to keep the thing stable. Now I also need a cross brace in the front, but you want to be careful in that if you have this cross brace too close to the front and too deep, your knees will hit it, and I certainly don't want that. So I put the cross brace back a little bit, and you know, it's not that deep. Now, the way I did this was they used some reverse joist hangers here. This is just an old 2x3 I had laying around. So that's gonna work fine. And then the next thing I need to do is figure out how to create a little cubby here for the PC. It's a tower PC. and I need some kind of little cubby here to hold that. All right, for the cubby here, I decided I really didn't want to overthink this. So all I really need is something to get it up off the floor, because I just don't like the PC sitting on the floor. So I just made a little shelf here. It's got its own support under here, but it's bolted to the side here. So, you know, if I ever need to change it in the future or any a different size or whatever, it'll be super easy. So I'm not going to overthink that. That'll be that. So the tower will just sit in there. I'll have access to the side for the cables and everything else. So that's all set. Now, turning our attention to the top, we've made some progress here. Let me try to pull back a little bit. So the basic construction here was just plywood, as you recall. And then on this top piece here, I had pine that was left over. Honestly, it was a little bit warped and I had a little trouble getting it all situated, but I got most of the warp out and we're in pretty good shape now. Again, this is a cheap project, not meant to be high-end furniture here. So we have individual cubbies here, which are open in the back, and I made them 19 inches so you could fit standard equipment in there. And then the middle section here with the monitor is going to be there, and there's also going to be a keyboard here. So this is really just a cubby for whatever, pencils, paper, whatever. And then you'll notice what I did was kind of relieve, this little corner here, just to give you a little bit more space on the surface itself. The top here I can use for whatever I want. Right now, I don't have speakers for the top here. I have the larger ones, which I showed you earlier, but I do have a monitor to go on top. So the last thing here was the kind of an arm to hold a laptop. Now this is just sitting here right now, but this actually looks pretty decent. For $33, I'm actually glad I bought it, because if I tried to do something homemade, it wouldn't have been as nice. So, this is just gonna get screwed through the top, and then there's an arm that comes off of that to hold a laptop. And all I wanna do is get it off the surface here. So if it's up off the side here, that's fine. That's all I really need to do. So we're in pretty good shape here. Now, one of the last things I gotta do is talk about finish. So there's so many different kinds of wood here. I used, two or three different types of plywood, pine, there's, a 2x, there's all different stuff here. So to tie it all together, I'm just gonna use paint. And I think that's the most practical way of doing it. So I'm gonna end up painting the base a black, a matte black, which will kind of just blend in with the rest of the room. And the top here, I've forgotten the name of the color, I'll look it up, but it's kind of a brownish gray, silver almost as well. It's kind of it's sort of nondescript, but it definitely blends in with, amps and things like that, the way they're usually colored. So I think that's gonna be fine. I'll just kind of blend in. And that way, if I, dig into the top in the future or whatever, I can always just paint right over it and touch it up, not a problem. All right, the top is painted up nicely and I'm working on the bottom as well. I decided to go to the store and splurge a little bit and get these grommets here. This company calls them furniture hole covers. But basically you just drill a hole, pop this grommet in it, and then you have a cover on the top. And it's just a nicer way to get the cables underneath. In this particular case, the keyboard, the musical keyboard, will be sitting on top here. So I do need to get cables from that through the top and to the personal computer underneath. So I decided it was worth it, and I'll probably put a few more in as well. A lot of the stuff, like the monitor, could just hang off the back, and that's fine with me. I don't really need to put a grommet up top here. Another issue I thought about was the power strip. Now, it's really nice to have these bigger power strips rather than little short jobbers, because there's a lot of space between the outlets, and a lot of these, I call them wall warts, they're basically little transformers and they take up a lot of space. So if you have a short power strip, you put one transformer on there, a wall wart on there, and it covers up the next outlet, and you don't get as many to use out of it. So I bought one of these. The trouble is it's a little bit long. This is a 4 foot, and this is the cheapest one I could find. I got it at Harbor Freight, actually. And it'll do my purposes fine. It's just, it's too long. It's actually 49 inches long. And if I try to mount it on the desk itself, I'm gonna run out of space. So I think I can open this up pretty easily. It's put together with screws there, you can see. And if I take two of the outlets off and then just, cover this end up, I should be in good shape. So I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna take it apart. All right, with this opened up, you can see how they did this. They just ran, single wires right down the line here until they get to each outlet. a receptacle, and they just solder that in there. So actually all I have to really do is clip off where I want it to end. So I'm going to remove the last two in the line here. So I'll go to this one, and it looks just like this, and I'll just clip that off, remove them, and then I'll just take a some tin snips and cut this to the length that I want, and I'll leave a little extra so I have a place to screw through just like they did here. So pretty simple. All right, so that's all shortened up and that looks good. I just painted that in there. I gotta let that dry, and then I can mount that strip and it's the right length, and now I'll have plenty of power. All right, here's the desk all finished and set up. I'm really pleased with the way it came out. All the dimensions are good. Everything worked out basically as I had hoped. So you got the set in a monitor here. I got the keyboard up on a stand, which I don't really use that much when you're actually, you know, using the software. And the MIDI keyboard, the musical keyboard, is what you use most. And I have that set up about 28 and a half inches off the floor, which is about piano height. So that's perfect. Plus I have an adjustable chair. Plenty of room under here for your knees. So that worked out great. And then this arm, I'm actually very pleased with. It was $33. I mean, you really couldn't beat it. So that's holding a laptop, and that is connected to, you know, some of this gear over here. So that works out great. And, you know, the speakers, granted, the so-called speaker stands are pretty cheap, and maybe someday I'll change that, but they're functional for now. So that works out. The height is good. In the back of the desk here, you can see I have the power strip mounted here, which worked out well, and you know, you have plenty of space for the wall warts, and then access in the back here for, in this case, I got some network gear and some hard drives and things like that. Underneath the desk, the PC worked out good, so now it's got a little stand here so you don't kick it and kind of keeps the dust away, so that worked out well. The cables are well hidden, and, so that worked out good. Now, I'll give you some dimensions if you want to try to make something like this for yourself. So we have the main desk here, which is about 58 inches. And I have, let me see, I think it was 30 inches for the depth that I ended up with. Let me just check that. Yeah, I ended up with 30 inches as a depth. And that worked out pretty well. That gives me enough room, you know, for the keyboard, for both keyboards, and room up here for the monitor. Now, the shelf here on the upper shelf, I ended up with about 11 inches in depth, and it goes the length of the whole desk, so that's another 58 inches. Height, I have 8 inches off the lower level here. Now the lower level, like I said, I have 28 and a half inches to the keys, which meant that this desk height is about 26 inches. So now, that may vary if you have a different keyboard, but for me that's what that worked out to be. So anyway, all in, I'm very happy with this, and if I had to buy all the materials, I would have spent about $150 maybe. Now I had all of it actually was scrap. The only thing I purchased personally for this was, you know, the grommets, I purchased the power strip, and I purchased this arm. So for me, the total investment was, I don't know, maybe $40, something like that. But you know, if you wanted to do this and buy it all straight from the Home Depot or Lowe's or whatever, plan on about $150, maybe $200, depending on what you do. But I think it's well worth it. And when these desks sell, professionally, if you buy them online, wherever you buy them, you know, you're going to spend at least $500 or $600, and more likely $15,000 to $2,000, which is crazy. And by doing it yourself, you can get your own dimensions, and just get what really works for you.